Fiji Pink isn't pink. A black sand bed will scratch the heck out of your aquarium. And a bare bottom tank, meaning no sand bed, is a terrible idea. There are three primary functions of a sand bed. Firstly, a sand bed is a home for beneficial bacteria. There is a lot of surface area on a sand bed, which can be home for all sorts of bacteria, which will help keep the nitrogen cycle moving along in your tank. The second function of a sand bed, it provides a home and food source for a lot of livestock in your tank. Many different types of fish and inverts live in and depend upon a sand bed for their survival. Nassaria snails, sand sifting gobies, pistol shrimp, goby pears, wrasses, and sand sifting starfish, just to name a few. And lastly, a sand bed is aesthetically pleasing. A vast majority of the time, a saltwater aquarium with a sand bed just looks better than a bare bottom tank. There are only two types of sand beds out there, a deep sand bed and a shallow sand bed. A deep sand bed, or DSB for short, usually has a depth of 6 to 8 inches. Not recommended for beginners or really anybody for that matter, a DSB attempts to create an anaerobic zone near the bottom of the sand bed where denitrifying bacteria can survive and thrive and help convert NO3 or nitrate back into N2 or atmospheric nitrogen gas. Deep sand beds take up a large portion of your tank, can be really difficult to clean, and if not done correctly, can create pockets of poisonous gas. Don't do a deep sand bed. A shallow sand bed, on the other hand, is any sand bed less than 2 inches, but they're usually around 1 inch in depth. Easy to maintain, aesthetically pleasing, and deep enough to provide habitat for most of your livestock, a shallow sand bed also has a ton of surface area for that beneficial bacteria to colonize and move the nitrogen cycle along. There isn't a whole lot to consider when choosing the right type of sand for your sand bed. The first consideration is color. There's white, there's off-white, and there's black. That's pretty much your only three options. Next up, you're gonna have to choose wet or dry sand. Dry sand is definitely a better value, but it arrives super dusty and doesn't contain any beneficial bacteria. You're going to need to rinse it several times with RODI water before putting it in your tank. Wet sand, while being a bit more pricey, comes packed with beneficial bacteria and should be placed directly into your tank sans rinsing. Lastly, you'll want to consider grain size. These range from sugar fine sand, which is about 0.25 millimeters in diameter, all the way up to crushed coral, which is 5 to 6 millimeters in diameter. Sugar fine sand is absolutely gorgeous. It won't allow fish food or fish waste to get trapped in it, but it will blow around your tank and cover everything with all but the gentlest of flow. Special grade sand, 1 to 2 millimeters in diameter, hits that sweet spot between sugar fine sand and crushed coral. It's small enough to still look nice and not trap much detritus, but it's heavy enough to not be blown around in moderate flow tanks. Crushed coral isn't the prettiest, but may be necessary for super high flow tanks out there. But fish food and fish waste will easily get trapped inside of it, so good maintenance routines are key. Here at BRS, we carry three different lines of CaribSea sand. The Aragonite line is your dry sand. Definitely the best value, but arrives super dusty and will require rinsing with RODI water before putting it in your tank. The Arag-Alive line is wet. It is sifted, rinsed, and then beneficial bacteria are added back into it. So when it comes home to you, put it directly in your tank and do not rinse it. And lastly, there is the ocean's direct line. This sand is taken directly from the ocean. It arrives wet, and it comes with all of the different strains of beneficial bacteria that you would find in the ocean. And just to make your lives a bit easier, here is a breakdown of all the CaribSea sands based on their grain size. First up, Bahamas oolite, 0.25 to 1 millimeter, also called sugar fine sand. Then you got Fiji Pink, 0.5 to 1.5 millimeter, decent option for low to moderate flow tanks. Thirdly is special grade, 1 to 2 millimeters, probably the best overall option for most tanks out there. Number four, Bimini Pink, 0.5 to 5 millimeters, largely made up of the smaller grain sizes with some larger crushed coral thrown in. Number five, original grade, 0.25 all the way to 6.5 millimeters, It's similar to Bimini Pink with a slightly larger range of grain size. Number 6, Natural Reef, 3 to 5 millimeter. No small pieces here, pretty close to crushed coral. Number 7, Florida Crushed Coral, 3 to 5.5 millimeters. The largest grain size offered, only meant for super high flow tanks. And lastly, you have Hawaiian Black, 0.25 to 3.5 millimeters. Quite chunky, its magnetic pieces will stick to your algae scraper and scratch your glass if you're not super careful. You could have just skipped this entire video and come straight to this point here. For us, there is just one choice that is super obvious, the most popular, and the best all-around sand for beginners. And that is the CaribSea Arag-Alive Special Grade. It just hits the sweet spot perfectly. It's not too small to blow around your tank, but it's not too large to allow fish food and waste to get trapped. It's small enough to give you a sense of those beautiful white sandy beaches with no large chunks to distract you from its consistency. And it is packed with beneficial bacteria, which will help cycle your tank quicker and requires no rinsing. Personally, I am also a fan of Fiji Pink. It does have a slightly smaller grain size, so you can run into trouble if you crank those wave makers up too high. I'm gonna recommend a 1-inch sand bed for beginners. It is deep enough to provide adequate habitat for your livestock as well as cover the glass bottom, but shallow enough for easy maintenance. How many pounds of sand you're going to need will depend on the footprint of your tank, whether it's wet or dry sand, and the given grain size. Lucky for all of us, BRS has a handy calculator. Enter the width and depth of your tank, either in inches or centimeters, the depth of the sand bed required, and the sand type. It's as easy as that. If not carefully maintained, your gorgeous new sand bed could become covered with different shades of green, browns, and purples, and also become a nutrient trap, constantly leaching out nitrates and phosphates and leading to some nasty nuisance algae outbreaks. Keep your sand bed looking the absolute best by watching this video right here. And as always, everyone, thanks for watching. Happy reefing, be well. We'll see you next time.